Hello, my name is Marion. I'm from the blog Miss Mustard Seed, and today we're talking about applying the second coat of milk paint. In my last video, I applied the first coat of milk paint on a different piece, but I talked through prepping the piece to paint, as well as what to expect from applying the first coat. This is a different piece I'm working on today, but this one already has one coat of milk paint on it. And as you can see, it's not the prettiest first coat. Especially white can look pretty ugly, but generally the first coat of paint, especially the first coat of milk paint because it's a little bit thinner, can look kind of bad. And that's when I usually get emails or phone calls saying like, I hate this, it doesn't look good, and they'll send me a picture. I'm like, just put another coat on. Like, give it time. Let the piece, like, finish it out before you judge it. You don't want to judge something halfway through the process. So it looks a little streaky right now. It's kind of visually textured. You can kind of see some spots where there were, it looks like there was some dripping, but I brushed it out. So there's no like textured drips, if that makes sense. It just kind of looks textured at this point. This is a piece that had a lot of texture to begin with. It had old paint on it that was kind of chipping. It was alligatored in a few places. And so I decided not to sand this piece before I painted it because I wanted to keep a lot of that texture. There are also a few places on this piece where the paint was really chipping and flaking off, and I just left it alone and painted very gently over it. So if you do have some chipping or flaking on your first coat, just go ahead and paint a second coat over it and be very gentle around those places where the paint is chipping. When you get to the point where you're sanding and distressing, it's just going to look magical. So it'll look like a bit of a mess during the process, but it'll look great when you're done. So, just got a text. Okay, so I'm going to just brush on a second coat of milk paint, and that's it. Like, it's pretty simple. There's not really much to it. And as you can tell, like, it looks so much more opaque. It just looks better already. It kind of pulls it all together. That second coat makes a big difference. If you're painting something that's really high contrast, like you're painting a black piece or really dark wood piece white, or you're painting a really white piece or light piece, a very dark color, you might end up having to do more than two coats. I'd say 95% of the pieces I paint only need two coats. Some of them need more than that. So just be aware. The nice thing about milk paint is it goes on nice and thin. You don't end up with a lot of, like, it doesn't start to get clumpy or grippy or any of that as you apply more coats of paint, as you would get with a thicker paint. Definitely can start to look gloppy at some point. Milk paint doesn't do that. You really can put multiple layers of paint on, and it doesn't end up getting that gloppy, thick coat of paint kind of look on it. So I'm just gonna paint this piece, brush it all out, and show you how it looks after the first, or after the second coat is all applied. Okay, there we go. So the second coat is done. And if you noticed, I sort of went back over a few spots. It's what I would call doing like a coat and a half of paint. So there were a few places I felt like I wanted a little bit more coverage. Milk paint dries super fast, so it was already dry enough to put just a little bit more paint over it just to get the coverage a little bit thicker. And I also went around on the legs just to make sure I caught any drips or anything. So especially with a piece with a lot of spindles and detail, it's a good idea to kind of go over it once more once you finish that second coat of paint, or once you finish really any coat of paint. A few things to note. First of all, on the last piece I painted, and I know I'm going to be asked on this piece as well, do I paint with the drawers, or why do I paint with the drawers left inside the piece? If the drawer is inset in the piece, meaning there's no overhanging lip around the edge, I'll just leave the drawers in when I paint. And the reason I do that, first of all, space issue. I don't have drawers out everywhere. Also, it's just not really necessary to take them out. I don't paint the sides of the drawers or the top of the drawer. I only want to paint the drawer face. The reason being, if you start painting the inside of the drawer, especially sort of on this outside edge, it can, even on the top edge, it can affect how the drawer fits into the recess, especially if it's a tight fit. It can make it so the drawer won't slide in and out evenly anymore. It's also, paint is going to be more likely to rub off there, and it kind of looks not so great after a while. So only paint the drawer front. If there is paint on the sides, I just take some sandpaper and sand it off, and that's it. So it goes back down to the wood. So I do leave the drawers in. Second thing was a question about drop cloths. As you can tell, I don't have one here. The reason I don't have one is this is my studio. This is a space for me to paint. I do fine art painting. I also do painted furniture. So this is a space for me to paint. And if I was using a really dark color, maybe I would put some paper down underneath. But these floors are painted in a semi-gloss paint, and so I'm able to wipe up any drips very easily with no problem. And I kind of prefer not having a drop cloth to kind of work around, especially when I'm working on a little rolly stool like this one. And yeah, so I just don't worry about it. And after a few years, if this floor needs it, I'll just put another coat of paint on it and no problem. So if I was painting over carpet or over a really nice wood floor or something, I would definitely put some paper or a drop cloth down. So I just wanted to answer that question. So now I'm going to let this completely dry, and then I will distress it and put the finish on it.